As promised to these kind viewers and as a follow-up to my previous video on this topic, here is a quick comparison in terms of stuttering between the current version of DXVK and its fork GPLAsync, i.e. an upgraded build of the now defunct async patch. As such, it still requires you to set the relevant environment variable to make it work. Don't forget it. Without further ado, let's go straight to AC Origins. During their first benchmark run, both DXVK and GPLAsync show 20 nearly invisible microstutters, even if the latter creates a much bigger cache than the former. Jaskus 2 exhibits a similar behavior to Origins. Four stutters roughly in the same spots, but the GPLA sync cache is almost 27 times larger. Instead, the original Crysis is a curious case. The patched DLL fails to prevent 5 high frame time peaks during the initial loop, despite its cache being more than twice that of the unpatched one. Thank you. finally, the iconic GTA 4. As observed in my earlier video, there's virtually the same amount of minor stuttering, especially at camera changes. And again, while GPLAsync creates a cache file, Bare DXVK does not. However, now I reckon I know why. Since version 2.1, it's no longer built unless necessary. Ergo, which project wins the comparison? Honestly, I cannot decree a clear-cut winner with these four games. As the saying goes, further research is needed. Nevertheless, to me, GPLAsync seems very promising indeed, so I will follow Fadzon's steady progress on their fork with great interest. And I encourage you to do the same too. Many thanks for tuning in and fare you well for now.